Final X is almost here, and this is gonna decide the world team, all three styles. We're gonna break down men's freestyle, all 10 weights. I got Tyler here. We're gonna be making picks. We'll see what weights we agree on and what weights maybe we don't. Maybe what weights we're gonna pick some upsets, but we're gonna march down all 10 weights, top to bottom, do a little preview, make our picks to set up for Final X. So, right off the bat, Thomas Gilman, world champ, multiple time world medalist, Olympic medalist, taking on the underdog, Zane Richards. Tyler, you giving Zane Richards any chance here, or are you going all Gilman?
So at the US Open, I actually picked Richards to beat Soriano. I don't know, I just think he's a really good freestyler, and I think he's coming into his own in freestyle, but there's no way I can pick him against Gilman. So I'm gonna go 2-0 Gilman on this
2-0
one.
2-0 Gilman.
Two matches, yeah. To zero.
Yeah, Zane Richards is a guy, he's made huge gains on the senior level. He beat a world medalist at World Cup, beat Nick Soriano, but I'm gonna agree with Tyler. I'm going 2-0 Gilman. I think that's a pretty confident pick, and we should look to see Gilman make some noise at Worlds again, be a world champ threat. So, 61, Vito Rougeau. We've heard it. I think Bader said it on the broadcast. Nobody's hotter than Vito Rougeau right now, but he's taking on Nashawn Garrett, and what we saw Nashawn Garrett do at World Team Trials was like really impressive, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Well, what's your thoughts on this matchup, Tyler?
I think they both look awesome right now, but something about Vito, I'm just not gonna count. Like, I'm so all in on Vito right now that I'm gonna go 2-0 Vito.
2-0?
Yeah, 2-0.
2-0, wow. Both these guys are ranked in the top 10 in the world, and I think either of these could go to the World Championships and you'd feel really confident in them. Sean Garrett is a guy who, if he gets up and if he's able to put together one or two, you know, big 4-point moves, he can take a match. And we saw at US Open, it was his closest match with Vito. It was Vito's closest match. We've seen them wrestle three times. Sean's been really close to beating him. I'm still gonna pick Vito, but I think Nashawn gets one match. I think he gets one match. All right. This 65 might be the match I'm most interested in. It might not be like the highest profile, but we got returning world silver medalist Yanni D against multiple-time NCAA champion Nick Lee. And here's the interesting part here is they've wrestled in folk style once, Yanni won, wrestled in freestyle once, Nick Lee won at the Olympic trials back in 2021, 2 years ago. Nick Lee won 16-8. He was 2 points away from a tech fall twice, maybe more than that. But, man, this match is really interesting. I'm gonna make my pick first. I'm gonna let you think about it. There is a part of me that wants to take the upset here.
Ooh.
You know, you go to Penn State and you think about Penn State, master game planners. They did it with Zane Rutherford, you know, when he beat Yanni. They know the game plan. I really wanna do it, but I'm gonna say Yanni has made progress enough, and I'm gonna say he goes 2-0. I'm gonna say 2-0 Yanni. That's my pick.
So for me, I think Nick Lee is like one of the most talented wrestlers out there, obviously. I think when he beat Yanni, it was on the backside of the Olympic trials.
Yep.
It's kind of sad boy hours. I'm not gonna say that was a fluke, but when I watch Nick Lee wrestle freestyle, it's just not the same Nick Lee that you see in folk style, I think. You see him kind of give up points. Like you saw even with Bo Bartlett at the US Open, that was what, a 10-10 match?
Yeah.
So I think that Yanni, just a little bit more experienced in freestyle, got to go to Worlds. I'm gonna go 2-0 Yanni.
Okay, we agree. So far we haven't picked, there hasn't been anything that we've picked different yet. We'll see if the last six weights lead to anything. I don't know if 70 kilogram is gonna tear us apart here, because Zane Rutherford might be the biggest favorite, if not one of the biggest, against Tyler Berger. They've wrestled one time in freestyle. Zane Rutherford, tech fall smash. We saw him go to Worlds last year, win a World Silver. He might be the favorite to win a world title this year at 70, so I think it's a no-brainer. It's almost almost next topic, and that's no disrespect to Tyler Berger. We saw him at the U.S. Open, put together incredible U.S. Open, best comeback, you know, best finish of the tournament. But it's all Zane for me. What are you thinking?
So I talked about how I feel like Nick Lee's style hasn't fully translated to freestyle yet. I think we kind of saw that in the beginning of Zane's freestyle career. Yeah. I feel like it's the tides have turned. I feel like Zane is really figuring out freestyle. Took home that world silver last year. I think it's just going to be up from here for him.
So yep.
I'm going to go 2-0.
Okay.
Zane.
All right. I'm going to let you intro 74 because I know what your take is here. So take us away.
I mean, so it's kind of weird, but in just like researching, you know, my job at Flow is to make videos. And I did a video on can Jason Nolf beat Kyle Dake? And it had me just kind of chasing down the rabbit hole of Nolf's career. And I mean, maybe I'm the only one, but I feel like he's underrated. Like, he only lost how many times in college? Twice? Both of them to Isaiah Martinez, I think. Mm-hmm. He's just, you watch him, he's just an athletic freak. He can do crazy things. So is Dake. But I just really like Nolf's trajectory. Am I fully confident in my pick? No, but I think if I'm going to pick an upset in this, it would be Nolf over Dake, which is why I'm going to go Nolf.
Love it.
2-1.
Wow.
On this one.
I love it. I love it. And like, as bold and as crazy as a pick is, I'm not too far away from it because Jason Nolf is getting better and better. I think he's ranked number 9 right now in the world at 74, which 74 is, I think, one of the toughest weights, if not the toughest weight in the world. He's beaten multiple world medalists over the last couple of years. We've seen him get better and better. Last year, like, everyone's mind has Kyle Dake smashing Jason Nolf from the Olympic trials, but they wrestled at Final X.
That's what I meant to bring
up,
too.
It was razor thin.
Nolf got the only takedown of the series.
Only takedown of the whole series. But I'm still going Dake. I'm gonna say Nolf gets one.
Ooh.
I'm gonna say he gets one, but I think Dake still gets it done. We've seen Nolf. He sometimes has a hard time generating his offense, and on someone like Dake, that can be problematic. Dake's so crafty, too. It's like, man, such a crafty guy.
You watched that Final X series from last year, and it felt like every time Nolf got up, or like from a shot clock point or from the takedown he had, Dake was like, okay, let me turn it on.
Yeah.
And he would just get the pushouts that he needed.
Yep.
That's definitely a factor.
All right. This match, rematch from last year, Jordan Burroughs, the King, versus Chance Marsteller. He is so, so good. He is one of the guys who I think maybe is underrated, even though he beat Burroughs last year. These two, they've wrestled 5 times in the last 2 years. Burroughs is 4-1 against Marsteller. This is the case for Burroughs, 4-1 against them. I think he's outscored him something like 22-3. Marsteller's only scored 3 points in the series. But you can't forget what happened last year at Final X. And how Marsteller really pushed Burroughs to the brink. And Marsteller's, he's not just a flash in the pan. He beat Savin Khoui, who beat Burroughs, Savin Khoui, the Iranian. Marsteller has a number of really, really good wins. One of the best freestyle guys in the world at 79 kilograms. With all of that said, I'm still picking Burroughs. Can't not pick him, but I'm going to say Marsteller steals another one from him.
Okay.
Tyler, what you got?
Man, I'm just too young. Like, I grew up with Jordan Burroughs.
Yeah.
He's always been the guy. He's been the guy that everyone's looked up to for the longest time. Maybe it's just my age, but I'll never pick against him to make a world team.
Never.
So, never. I'm gonna go 2-0 Burroughs on this one, actually.
Yeah.
Not to disrespect Chance Marsteller, because, like, I think if Chance Marsteller wins the series, mm-hmm. I got him for a world medal, for sure. Like, this guy has gotten so good, but I'll just never pick against Burroughs.
Yeah, Marsteller's a guy, I said in another video, like, he is game planner, maybe the best in America. Had never beaten Alex Deringer before the U.S. Open. He was, I think, 0-4 against him. Put together a beautiful game plan. It's not always pretty, but, man, he gets the job done.
Yeah.
All right. We got Penn State on Penn State Crime here, 86 kilograms. World Olympic champion David Taylor versus 3-time NCAA champion Aaron Brooks. This could be like the present against the future here. David Taylor, man, he might be pound for pound the best guy in the world. What do you got? What do you got here, Tyler?
So for me, like, I think Brooks is the future of this weight class in the United States, for sure. But David Taylor, like, you look at Brooks wrestling Zahid at Final X, right? At the US Open. Zahid gets up 6-0, Brooks runs him down. I don't see any scenario where Brooks is able to run David Taylor down. David Taylor does not get tired. And in my opinion, David Taylor is a little bit more skilled than Zahid, too. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I still have that burned in my memory. I was at Worlds last year. He beat Yazdani 7-1. Like, I just don't see that David Taylor losing to Brooks yet. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go 2-0 Taylor.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, you said it. And for a lot of the same reasons, I'm picking that as well. Oh, man, that's a bad 2. 2-0. I don't know what that is. But, yeah, we see David Taylor. He doesn't get tired, right? Never slows down. Technique is incredible. Yazdani is the guy in the world who is known for melting people. And he doesn't melt David Taylor. I really am excited to see it because I think it's like the preview of Olympic trials next year, maybe. And then seeing Brooks, go beyond 2024, he could be our guy going through the next squad. So I think this will be great for Aaron Brooks. All right. Mike Mock, kind of the surprise US Open winner, takes out Nate Jackson, takes out Colin Moore. He's in the finals. He didn't even know he was going to go 92 until like a couple weeks before the US Open. And then Zahid was maybe the favorite to make 86, and now he's sitting at 92. And man, how good did Zahid look at the World Team Trials? So good. I'm picking Zahid here. I think with what we saw, he might be undersized, but his offense is like the difference maker. And so with what we saw from him at World Team Trials, feel really confident. I'm gonna go 2-0. I just cannot make a T. 2-0 Zahid. You picking anything different here, Tyler?
So earlier I said that I think David Taylor is more skilled than Zahid, and that's a huge compliment because I think Zahid is one of the most skilled people on this entire list. Like, mm-hmm. Zahid, his offense, like where he can score from, where he can wrestle from, is just crazy. And especially watching him run through that World Team Trials tournament, I just don't see Mike Mock beating him. I'm gonna go 2-0 Zahid.
Yeah. Yeah. Man, it'll be interesting to see because Mike Mock was like a 97 guy too.
Yeah, true.
So the size difference could play a factor.
Especially in Zahid's gas tank.
Just gonna say, we've seen Zahid kind of struggle later in matches. So could we be underestimating? Maybe. All right, man, this might be the main event. Kyle Snyder, Jaden Cox, world champ versus world champ, Olympic gold medalist versus Olympic bronze medalist. We're finally going to see it in, like, the most meaningful atmosphere. We saw it at the Rudas Supermatch last year, and they wrestled twice there. The first match, like, Snyder won both of them, and I think that puts something in people's minds. Like, okay, Kyle Snyder is, like, the favorite here. He's a big favorite. But that first match, that was razor thin. It was 5-5, really close. And Jaden's put on some size since then, like, significant size. Last year, he was 92. He was a 92 guy. He looks every bit of 97. Yeah. Like, he's cutting to make that weight. All right, Tyler, tell us what you think. Unbiased opinion.
Unbiased. So, completely unbiased. Jaden trains at University of Michigan, the best place in the world to train. I think that, no, but genuinely, Jaden, watching their match, I was at the Super Match last year. Their match happened at, what, like 2 a.m.? Like, it was insanely late.
The first match was
super close, and Christian said it in his video. Jaden looked at him and was like, man, I just want to go to bed. Like, it didn't feel... After Jaden lost that first match, like, it's kind of one of those things where there's no pressure on this matchup. Doesn't matter. It felt like maybe Jaden didn't want to have to go to a third or something like that. I don't know. What I think happens this time is Jaden wins the first match, Kyle wins the second match, Jaden wins in the best of three. I mean, ooh. I saw it at Final X last year.
All right.
Nate Jackson took a match from Jaden, and on the way back up to the practice room where the guys kind of like warm up for their next match, Jaden yelled at him. He goes, "You're not going to take this one." He goes, "I live for best of threes."
All right.
I think Jaden Cox is going to live for the best of three, and I think he's going to take it from Snyder.
I love it. Yeah,
2-1 Jaden.
We're only, what, like 2 or 3 days away. This, and like just talking about this match gets me so fired up. Kyle Snyder is, he has made every team since 2015. And I think he's only lost one match in a best of three to Jake Varner. But the reason, so my pick is Snyder. I'm gonna go 2-1 Snyder. My reasoning for this is Kyle Snyder, he wrestles, I think, harder than any other 97 kilo guy in the world. The way that he hand fights, his pace, you know, obviously big, strong, he's very technical. I honestly think that Jaden putting on the extra size, I think that might actually hurt him.
Really?
Because I think, I don't know if he's gonna be able to keep up with the pace of Snyder.
Okay.
I think they're very evenly matched in their offense. We saw both of them were able to finish takedowns, both of them were able to get to their step outs. And so I think in a best of three series, I think it actually might come down to the pace and just the hand fighting, control of mat ability that Snyder. We saw in the Rudis, we watched them yesterday, the matches, or 2 days ago. Mm-hmm. A lot of the situations came down to like the over-under position.
Yeah.
And so maybe that's even a position we watch out for. Who's able to win that early on in the matches? Be really interesting to see. But
one thing we forgot to bring up in this video is how slippery will Jaden Cox be at a higher weight?
Yeah.
He's gonna be slippery.
Yeah. That's true. He's gonna be, you know, he's gonna have so much more fluid in him. He's gonna be so hydrated. It's gonna be, yeah, that could be the X factor. We never know. Maybe I should change my prediction. All right, last match, Gable Steveson, Mason Paris. Gable coming back, Olympic champion. We saw him in the U.S. Open, and the question was, man, how's he gonna do? Mason had this incredible season. Is he gonna catch up? And that's what Gable said at the end. He's like, oh, he's catching up. He's catching up. It's like, oh, no, he's not, because we saw how dominant he was. Tyler, I know this one. I know you can't be unbiased here, right?
My completely unbiased opinion is Mason Paris over Gable Steveson, 2-1.
There it is, 2-1.
And is it a bold pick? No. What I think is going to happen, you know, Mason, his biggest move, his dump. That's how he pins Zare.
Yep.
He hasn't done it on Gable Steveson yet.
Hasn't tried it. Yeah.
Is it hard to do on Gable Steveson? Maybe. But I think we're going to see Mason dump Gable, pin.
Yep.
Gable's like, okay, let me win a match. Yep. Then Mason's like, okay, let me dump him and pin him again.
All right.
And that's how it goes.
There it is.
2-1, Mason Paris.
All right. For those of you who don't know, Tyler, he wrestled at Michigan, so he's friends
that with, has nothing to do with this.
Yeah, but it has nothing to do with it. Do with it. This is integrity. but yeah, I think the clear pick is Gable's obviously established himself as the best in the world, best in the country. Just so impressive. So glad he's back. Sorry, Tyler. I think Gable takes this 2-0. I am interested to see if Mason's able to make any kind of adjustments. I would love to see Mason go overseas and maybe wrestle in a ranking series tournament or two and test himself against some of the best in the world, because I think he is right up there. I think he is. If he went to Worlds, I think he'd be in medal contention. I'd like to see him wrestle some of the other guys. But all right, we did it. I think I took a lot of safe picks. Tyler, you were a little bit more bold here. We're gonna see something crazy happen. We always see it at Final X. Last year we saw, you know, Seth Gross beat Dayton Fix. We saw Hayden Zilmer beat Quiz. Marsteller took a match from Burroughs. What's it going to be this year? We don't know, right? But
no idea.
Final X is going down June 10th. That's Saturday, June 10th. First session starts at 2 p.m. Eastern. That's all round one. Second session is at 6 p.m. You can watch it only one place. That's on Flow Wrestling. You're going to want to tune in. You're not going to want to miss a match. It's going to be incredible.